So I plan on making $100,000 by the end of the year. Do you want to know how I plan on doing this? Well, stay tuned and find out. What's up, guys? I'm Mike Romero. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. And I'm going to show you exactly my game plan and how I plan on making $100,000 by the end of the year. Well, that's more kind of a clickbaity title that I have for this video. It's not making $100,000, but acquiring $100,000 in net worth by the end of the year. I'm gonna break down where I'm at, how I have this coming in, what accounts I'm using, and how I plan on making it to that $100,000 mark by year's end. But first, this video is brought to you by none other than Webull. If you wanna download Webull, hit the link in the top pinned comment. Download Webull using your first $100 and you will get two free stocks valued up to $1,800, guys. So that would be a nice beginning to your $100,000 portfolio, net worth, whatever the case may be. Even if you don't like the platform, you can just sell the stocks and put the money back in your bank account. Also, smash that thumbs up button for the YouTube algorithm because it really helps this channel more than what you guys know. And if you're new here, don't forget to hit the little red subscribe button, turn it gray to join us. Family, we have growing, guys. So everybody knows Warren Buffett's famous saying of, you know, your first $100,000 is the hardest to reach, but it is the most influential to reach. It is the most important milestone in net worth to reach, because everything after that is going to be substantially easier to make. And well, that's what I'm on right now. I'm working on hitting to that first 100K mark, first six figures. And I have been working on this for about 2 years now, and we will see exactly where I am in that race to acquire $100,000 in net worth. Now, there are three principles that I go by in my journey to acquiring all this, right? First one is keeping my spending pretty low. That means keeping my bills low, keeping my fun money low, keeping pretty much my spending, any unnecessary spending, at a minimum, right? Now, I still do go out and I still do fun things. I still do things I like to do. I just don't have much bills. I kind of formed my life to not really have many bills. Everything I have is paid off. I literally don't have loans. I don't have anything like that. So everything I own is bought cash. Number two is be consistent when it comes to investing and saving, right? Don't slack off. Continue to do it. Be consistent with it. You want to do it every week, every time you get paid, or once a month, whatever it is, be consistent and don't just frolic off because you are doing very well in your portfolios, you're doing very well in your spending. It's okay to, you know, give yourself a little leeway every now and then, but make sure you have small goals set and reached before you actually do any, you know, spending or any cutting back on investing to spend money that you wouldn't necessarily do. And number three, keep everything as automated as possible. So basically what happens is whenever I get paid for my day job, everything is automated. I have money go to my bills account, money go to all of my brokerages, money goes to my 401k, money goes to my ESPP, money goes into my savings account. And what I have left in my original spending account is what I have left over for groceries, gas, and if I wanted to, if I have more money left over, more saving and more investing, which is usually what I do. Anytime I have money left over from my previous check, I either dump it all in savings or put it all in investing. So where am I at in this journey to 100K? Let's find out and see exactly what I'm holding, where I'm at, and how I'm acquiring this. So I am achieving all of this through three different types of income: active, semi-passive, and passive income. Active being my day job, because I have to be there, give up my time to make money. Semi-passive being something like YouTube, right? I put all the work up front and I make money on it years and months and whatever times to come, right? Number three being passive income. That being interest on stocks, interest on cash positions, dividends, staking cryptos, interest from cryptos, and all of that. I do not own any type of rental property or anything like that. Most of my money is in the stock market and in the crypto market. We're gonna take a look at that right now. So my biggest account so far is my retirement accounts, where I hold around $34,445 in those accounts. And that is split between two different accounts, my 401k and my ESPP. If you don't know what 401k is, it's basically like a retirement account your company sets up. I do get a match from that. It's a 5% match. So yeah, that works out pretty well. They match up to 5%. And the next is the ESPP or Employee Stock Purchase Program, where my company is a publicly traded company. So I get a 15% discount whenever I buy through this ESPP program. So I utilize that as well. Next, we have after-tax brokerage accounts, being my Robinhood, Webull, M1 Finance, and Acorns. So all of those together are around $22,687. Robinhood being the largest at around $16K, Webull at around $500, M1 at around $6K, and Acorns at around $129. Now, that was a lot higher, but I took that money out in order to invest it elsewhere. And we kind of restarted the process on Acorns. So those two categories are pretty much stock market based. The next category we have is crypto, where I have around $5,800 invested. And this is in quite a few accounts. I actually hold this in Coinbase, Voyager, and PancakeSwap, or the Trust Wallet. So with this crypto, I'm actually earning money from interest rates from holding, you know, stable coins and things like that. I'm also earning interest in the actual raise of value of the coin itself. I'm also getting money from staking some crypto. In an after-tax brokerage, I'm getting money from my cash positions, dividends, and I'm getting money from the interest earned from holding these positions, you know, capital gains. And so finally, my final position is cash. This would be around $7,000 I have in cash in an actual account though, right? We keep that in a high interest savings account. That way it makes more than it would in a regular account. But with interest rates being at an all-time low, I'm actually not getting that much money from it. So I could essentially make more money with it doing something else, but that's okay. I actually like having some cash on the sideline just in case something happens with my vehicle, something happens, you know, in case I were to lose my job, something happens that I get hurt and I can't work. That's why I keep a large cash position, and I'm actually currently adding more to this as of right now. So with all of these combined, I'm actually making well over $100 in passive income, pure passive income. That would be interest and from dividends. That does not include my capital gains from the actual price of the stock and cryptos going up. So I'm floating at around 70,000. That is quite a bit, right? That's a lot more than most people have. But most of this is in accounts that I would be taxed heavily if I were to take it out. So I'm kind of what you call cash poor, right? This is all net worth. This is for later on in the future. So with it being September, that means I would have 3 months left to make what, around 30 grand to make that 100K mark. So with the way the markets have been going, obviously I rely heavily on the stock market to make most of this income and make most of my money multiply, right? Well, the way the markets have been going, I've been buying the dips, which have been working very well for me. But I think me relying on crypto, hopefully we see another crypto run, and I will definitely be able to get a lot closer to that 100K mark. I don't know if I'll reach that 100K mark by the end of this year. I am currently investing and planning on it though, right? I am still encouraging myself to see the year's end and that 100K mark as my goal. I do not want to slack off. I am actually even ramping up more and more, saving and investing as much money as I can so I can hit that goal. Even if I don't hit that goal this year, I am acting like I will hit it, right? It's all a mental game as of right now for me. Most of this is coming from the actual job that I work. The next is coming from this passive income I'm getting generated from all of these accounts, right? And then we have YouTube. I do make money from YouTube every month. It's not much. It's a couple hundred bucks, but I do always put every cent of that either in these crypto accounts or in one of these after-tax brokerages. So with that being said, stay tuned for the next episode to see. I may break down even further and show you where we're at with this Road to 100K challenge. I'm not gonna show you any of the hard numbers just yet. I will in due time though. So keep an eye out for the next installment of this Road to $100,000 video or whatever I plan on naming it. So sitting at around 70 grand right now. Let's see exactly what we're gonna be at on the next video. I may do another video in a month. So check out for the end of October. I'll show you another video like this and show you where we're at. Hopefully we are closer to that $80,000 mark. Though I am, like I said, actively acting as if I will reach that 100K mark. I am investing and saving aggressively, very aggressively. So that's my plan. That's my goal. I'm relying heavily on crypto and these accounts for the stock market to see that 100K net worth. Let's see if we can make it. But guys, look, if you enjoyed this video, smash that thumbs up button for the YouTube algorithm. And if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit the little red subscribe button, turn the gray to join this little family we have, guys. Let me know in the comments below if you think I'll hit that mark by the end of the year. It's okay if you don't. Like I said, realistically, I don't think I will, but I'm still actively acting as if I will, because it's a mental game as of right now. Even if we don't hit it by the end of the year, we will be very close in 2022. So with that being said, if you want to continue your journey to financial enlightenment with me, go ahead and click one of these videos. I'm going to get out of here. Peace, love, and prosperity.